Welcome to Imagination.
Hello there, everyone, and welcome to another edition of Imagination. This time, we're celebrating 20 years of someone very special.
On today's Imagination. A special feature on Crayon, Shinchan, celebrating its 20th anniversary. Manga, TV anime, theatrical anime, and games. It's a popular family entertainment around Japan and the world. We'll be unveiling the secrets behind Shinchan's enormous popularity by visiting its production studio. A creator's interview meet anime director Takashi Taniguchi, a multi-talented creator who directs, writes, composes, does voiceovers, and even produces theme songs all by himself.
And we're straight in at the deep end with our Ganige topic, and hopefully Dominic is waving rather than drowning.
Certainly drowning in sweat here in explosively hot Tokyo, Tim. Let's get on with the latest topic. New action game Lord of Arcana is now available. Keep the mighty monsters in real-time team action. Lord of Arcana is a multiplayer action game set in a majestic fantasy world full of mighty monsters. It will be released for PlayStation Portable on October 14th. The player in the game is a Slayer Warrior who undergoes dangerous missions to fight countless monsters. It's a grand-scale adventure with thousands of weapons. The multiplayer mode supports up to 4 players, but the game offers missions for single-player mode as well. Be sure to check it out this autumn. The fantasy world of gigantic monsters will be waiting for you. Marduk Scramble. Theatrical anime based on an award-winning cyberpunk novel is being unveiled. The original novel has sold over 500,000 copies and has even won the Japan SF Grand Prize. Part 1 of this theatrical trilogy will be released this autumn. The story is about a girl who is able to tap into electronic signals. She uses her power to pursue criminals and the secrets of her own past. It has an elaborate worldview, and its profound theme of life has earned it a grand reputation.
For anyone who thinks we've been overdosing on Iza and Faye recently, fear not, we have Bene with us today.
Hey, how are you?
I'm good, good to see you. Have you been busy recently?
Yeah, I've been doing so much research.
What for this time?
For my special favorite anime, Crayon Shinchan.
Crayon Shinchan?
Yeah!
Now, I've known for a long time, probably nearly 10 years maybe.
No, actually they're celebrating their 20th anniversary this year since its first operation.
I didn't realize it was 20.
Yeah.
Wow.
And you know that Shinchan is the most famous 5-year-old boy in the world. He's really my favorite character.
Well, because I knew him from a little girl, Japanese girl, who I used to teach English to a long, long time ago. She used to love Crayon Shinchan, so I've known him since then.
Yeah, but for those who are not aware or don't know what's so great about Crayon Shinchan, first of all, check this out.
This year, Crayon Shinchan is celebrating its 20th anniversary. It's a comedy depicting the life of Shinosuke Nohara, a cheeky, mischievous kindergartner who drives adults mad. He is adorable and honest, but his extreme actions and words are always embarrassing the adults. It's popular family entertainment around Japan as well as around the world.
それでお目目パッチリに似てるわけか。またやるか。バッチリ化けましたな。Korean name is Dango. Dango is very
kawaii and humorous.
Europe.
Do you know the name of this guy?
I do. That is definitely Grand Shinchan.
Whoa, you know it.
I know that they did a hilarious dub I saw one time. It could be popular in the States.
Mm-hmm. Crayon Shinchan was born in 1990. Yoshito Usui, the author, began serialization and weekly manga action. Although weekly manga action is targeted at the youth generation, Crayon Shinchan actually started out as a comedy manga for adults. We asked about its beginning. The anime broadcast, which began in 1992, triggered a social phenomenon in which kids were imitating Shinchan's behavior, turning Shinchan into a national icon. Crayon Shinchan is set in Kasukabe City, Saitama Prefecture, where the author grew up. Everywhere you look in Kasukabe, there is Crayon Shinchan, and now it's a global tourist destination. In 2005, the Shinchan family officially became registered as special residents of Kasukabe, helping to promote the city.
春日部市の住民としてクレヨンしんちゃんの一家がですね、ご主人になっていただいて、本当に春日部市が注目されているということと、そういうものをですね、子育て支援とか暮らしの方にですね、PRに役立っています。はい。Despite
its steady success, a very sad and unfortunate incident recently occurred. Last September, the author suddenly passed away in a mountaineering accident. The death of Usui, the founding father of Shinchan, brought about great sadness in Japan. Manga Action's former chief editor says,
20年, Usui先生は, クレヨンしんちゃんという作品, ほぼ一本でずっとやってこられて、 まあ、随分苦しいこともあったと思うんですが、私どもは、薄井先生のスタッフと一緒に、引き継いでいきたい。新しい形で、これは漫画も、テレビも、映画も、同じような形で引き継いでいきたい。
We cannot let Crayon Shinchan just fade away. With the aid of passionate staff and fans, the anime will be continuing. Today, we'll be exploring the secrets behind Crayon Shinchan's popularity. Today's commentator is a manga critic and an expert on Crayon Shinchan, Tsunehiro Uno.
Crayon Shinchan is known all over the world, but what would you say is the attraction of Shinchan?
大きくて二つあると思うんですよ、ポイントって。一つはやっぱり、もう無論のことをやっぱり、切れ味の鋭いギャグですよね。やっぱすごい鋭い大人社会への風刺があったりとか、まあ本当にちょっと、
ご自身のギャグがあったりとか、結構本気で読者を笑わせようとしてますよね。まあ、それが一個挙げられると思うんですね。で、もう一個は、クレヨンしんちゃんって、新しいんですよ。それはどういう意味で新しいかというと、例えばサダエさんとか、ちびまる子ちゃんとかって、やっぱりもう今でも日本にない風景なんですよね。60年代とか、やっぱり高度成長の頃のやっぱり風景っていうのを見て、やっぱりこう、ああ、こんな風景があった、懐かしいなと思う、漫画なんですよ。同じこう、家族ものっていうか、ファミリー向けの、アニメや漫画としても。でも、クレヨンしんちゃんってやっぱりリアルなんですよね。90年代以降の日本というか、やっぱりすごい郊外に建て売り住宅を買って、車を持っていて、で、核家族ですよね。うん、で、ある教科書には、もう核家族の例、日本に多い核家族の例として、クレヨンしんちゃんの例が使われてるぐらいなんですよ。だから、おじいちゃん、おばあちゃんとはもう同居してなくて、まあ、サラリーマンのお父さんと専業主婦のお母さんと子供が2人みたいな。これやっぱりこう、新しい日本の、やっぱりここ数十年の日本を支えてきた、こう、家族のモデルっていうのを、そういう端的に描いてるんですね。そのやっぱりリアリティっていうものが、やっぱりすごく受け入れられてるのかなと思うんですよ。
Is it also one of the reason why it's accepted in the world?
まあやっぱりクレヨンしんちゃんって、やっぱりすごいアジア圏に人気があるんですよね。で、やっぱりアジア圏って結構ほら、儒教の文化とかあるじゃないですか。だから結構大人の人が、そういう、なんかこう、尊敬しなきゃいけないっていう文化がある中で、まあ、そういった大人社会の、こう、なんかこう、嘘とか、建前とかを、やっぱりクレヨンしんちゃんが、やっぱり子供であれがゆえに、欲望の赴くままに行動して告発するっていう。だからこれがやっぱり多分、ヨーロッパとかだったら、もっと政治風刺とかになったと思うんですよね。でもクレヨンしんちゃんってやっぱり政治風刺ではなくて、大人世間風刺みたいなものになるじゃないですか。それがね、やっぱり特にアジア圏における人気の秘密だと思うんですよね。
So we have a manga that then became an anime and then that turned into a film or a movie. They're all Crayon Shin-chan, but what is the difference between the three?
Manga の方が、まあ、やっぱり一番オーソドックスだと思うんですよね。で、アニメはやっぱり、特にテレビは遊んでますよね。いろんなこと試してます。まあ、いろんなこう有名なアニメ監督はクレヨンしんちゃんからこう輩出されてるんですね。クレヨンしんちゃんをきっかけにいろんな演出がブレイクしてるんですよ。で、それぞれのやっぱり作風の違いとかもやっぱりありますし、で、それが特に一番出てるのは映画版なんですよね。やっぱりもうクレヨンしんちゃんって言ったらもう日本国民誰でも知ってるって安心感が出てないですか。だから最初にこのキャラクターはこういう人物とかそういう説明とか一切いらないんですよね。もうだからすごく好きなことができるんですよ。だからそれもやっぱり彼らの監督のアニメ版の監督たちのやっぱり作家性みたいなものをすごい引き出してるのかなと思うんですよね。
Yeah, but Crayon Shin-chan became a symbol in Japan. But let's find out more about his attraction.
Crayon Shin-chan's Nohara family is made up of Shinosuke, Misae the mother, Hiroshi the father, Himawari the younger sister, and their dog Shiro. Shinosuke is a mischievous kid who's always causing trouble.With his funny kindergarten friends, it's an entertaining story of constant laughter. Some parents, however, consider it to be a bad influence on their children, as it contains scenes of disrespecting elders and vulgar behavior.
平成の、日本の典型的な家族を描いた作品の中で、例えば親を呼びつけにする子供がいても全然おかしくないし、家族が一つにまとまってる一つのシンボルだと思うんですね。ですから、いろいろ苦情はありましたけども、ともかくそれは変えないと。一番家族を中心にして、物語を作っているんだし、薄井先生もそういうふうに作っていただいてるんで、これは変える必要はないというふうに僕はずっと思っています。
Crayon Shin-chan's underlining theme is the family bond. Although Shinosuke is always being scolded for his vulgar and silly behavior, his parents also dearly love him. At its core, Crayon Shin-chan is a depiction of a tight-knit family.
Shinosuke! Yo, Nikira! Otanpo Nito!
Very comical, very humoristic, and very...
Cynical at the same time. It is great. I mean, really, it makes, I don't have to, like, force out a laugh. It just comes out naturally. It's perfect. It really suits it. And that's the thing also, Crayon Shin-chan, it's not that cute. And I think that's actually, that makes it attractive as well. It does, it certainly does for me. And the humor is, you know, it's not just sort of cute or silly, it's a little bit dirty, and I know British people, we love a bit of toilet humor.
But also this piece was criticized, gets a lot of criticism, I guess. What do you think about that?
これに関してはですね、やっぱりこう、クレヨンしんちゃん僕擁護したいんですよ。やっぱりこういったなんかこう、ある種の下品なところとか、やっぱりこう、大人たちの本音を暴くようなところが面白いわけじゃないですか。あの物語ってやっぱり風刺もあってもいいし、毒もあってもいいし、そういった豊かさっていうのが、やっぱり本来こういったこう、